89. Going to head to the welterweight division. Jeff Whipple, 2-0. Going to face Perry Stargell, 3-1. Whipple, 2-0. Debuted all the way back in 2010 and then got back into action in March at Hard Rock MMA 87. Both of his wins are by submission, and Scott, our third Patriot MMA fighter of the night already.
Yeah. Like I said, there's a bunch of them on the card, it looked like. So Daryl Ray has assembled himself a group, and they come out with the American flag.
Taking the Patriot MMA name to heart, I guess.
Yep. And he's got the American flag shorts, which makes sense now. Brandon Wren also had American flag shorts, which I thought about. I didn't put the two and two together, but now I'm getting it.
Coming out to some Michael Jackson as well, so that's never a bad thing.
Nah, not at all.
Whipple, 26 years old. He's going to be in the red corner and bring out his opponent.
Perry Stargell trains at Vision MMA, coming off a split decision loss. And he's got wins over Brian McDowell and Justin Collette at Turfway. And interesting choice of music.
And Perry Stargell, and coming out of Vision, pretty much all those guys are characters. But
they are.
I got to tell you, 21 years old, I've become a fan of Perry Stargell. I called two of his first three fights. Actually, both of them were at Turfway.
Always.
And one of the interesting things was, he took on in his third fight, took on a much more experienced Brian McDowell and really controlled that fight throughout.
Yeah.
And was able to pick up a decision win over a guy who had 17 fights at the time.
Yeah.
And holds belts all over the state of Kentucky. And, you know, another one of, I guess, the top 170-pound prospects in the state. But Stargell himself has been making some waves here early in his career.
Absolutely.
Unfortunately, he came up short in his last bout, but looking to get back on the winning track here at Hard Rock MMA. Welterweight bout here at Hard Rock MMA 89. Jeff Whipple in the red, white, and blue trunks. Perry Stargell in the black, trimmed in red. And Gary Copeland is the referee for this bout. I think this is one of the ones that a lot of people had circled on their fight cards.
This
is an interesting matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't really see it leaving the first round.
Stargell comes out southpaw.
Oh!
Whipple immediately catches him and throws a couple of extra punches there for good measure.
Yeah.
Wow.
Stargell came in and he threw the punch and he overextended and
didn't even see what caught him.
He got caught with an overhand after he threw it, and it was right on the jaw, unfortunately.
And as you said, it didn't leave the first round, didn't even leave the first 15 seconds.
Nah, not at all.
And what a way to get your first knockout win. For Jeff Whipple. Stargell still wobbly here, and you see the blood over the mouth.
Yeah.
And that just is one that caught him right on the button.
You're unstoppable.
And no matter
who
you are, if you get caught there with a punch that hard, you're going out.
Yeah.
Whipple is being very respectful here.
Yeah, he is.
His corner is enjoying the win.
Yeah, but he's being very, very professional in his attributes. And
ladies and gentlemen, 6 seconds.
Wow, I don't know what the Hard Rock Record knockout is, but 6 seconds has got to be cutting it pretty close.
Six seconds for Jeff Whipple, and he is 3-0. And after a performance.